Now, Hill cipher is also a substitution cipher which takes in m successive letters of plain text and substitutes for them m ciphertext letters. And this substitution is determined by m linear equations. Now, just like Caesar's cipher or any other classical encryption technique, each alphabet is assigned a numerical value. So, if I consider the alphabets A to Z, we assign the numerical values 1, 2, 3 up to 25. So, we are operating in mod 26 in general. Right? So, now in Hill cipher, we have m linear equations. If I have m linear equations, then we substitute m plain text letters with m ciphertext letters. Now, for example, let us consider n equal to 3. When m is equal to 3, we consider 3 plain text letters. Let me call this as P1, P2, P3. And these 3 plain text letters are substituted with 3 ciphertext letters C1, C2, C3. Okay? Now, what are the equations? The equations are as follows. C1 equals K11 P1 plus K12 P2 plus K13 P3 operating in mod 26. Right? Assuming that there are 26 letters A to Z, we operate in mod 26. So similarly, C2 equals K21 P1 plus K22 P2 plus K23 P3 again operating in mod 26, and C3 equals K31 P1 plus K32 P2 plus K33 P3 again operating in mod 26. Now, can this be written in the form of a matrix? Yes. So this can be represented in the form of a matrix as C1, C2, C3, which is equal to K11, K12, K13, K21, K22, K23, K31, K32, K33 into P1, P2, P3 operating in mod 26. Right? So this is a 3x1 matrix, this is a 3x3 matrix, and this again is a 3x1 matrix. Right? So essentially, if m is equal to 3, I need to have a 3x3 matrix which does the process of encryption. So this 3x3 matrix, when multiplied with the 3 plain text letters, the numerical values of the 3 plain text letters would give me the numerical values of the 3 ciphertext letters. So this can be represented as matrix C equals matrix K into matrix P in mod 26. Right? So instead of 3, if I have m equations, I have m cross 1 equals m cross m equals m cross 1. Right? So this matrix K happens to be the encryption matrix. Now the process is not over. Once the ciphertext is obtained, at the receiving end we need to decrypt and get back the plain text. So therefore, how do I decrypt this? So we have the encryption algorithm as C equals K into P mod 26. So C equals K into P mod 26. Right? So to get the plain text, let me multiply on both the sides with K inverse. So K inverse into C gives me K inverse into K into P mod 26. Right? So K inverse into K inverse into the matrix is the identity matrix. So P is nothing but K inverse into C mod 26. So the whole idea is, if I have the encryption matrix K, I also need to have the inverse of K in mod 26 or in any given mod value M, right? So now the condition for encrypting using Hill cipher is that we cannot just consider a matrix K. I need to have the encryption matrix K. We also need to have the inverse of K in the given mod value, and only then we can continue with the process of encryption and later do decryption too, right? So before we proceed by taking an example, let us see how we can find the inverse of matrix K in a given mod value M. But that's very important. So for simplicity, let me consider a 2 cross 2 matrix. First, A equals 1, 3, 4, 3, mod 5. Right? So if this happens to be the encryption matrix K, then we have 2 characters of plain text which are being encrypted at one time to give 2 characters of ciphertext. So I have mod 5, so we need to find the inverse. So inverse in general is given by, if I have a 2 cross 2 matrix, it's very easy for us to find the inverse. The easier method is interchange the principal diagonal elements and put a negative sign for the other elements, right? This is a shortcut way of finding the inverse, divided by the determinant value A. Right? Okay, so let's try to find the determinant of A. So it is 3 minus 12, which is equal to minus 9. So the minus 9 is not a valid number in mod 5. So to get a valid number in mod 5, I need to add multiples of 5. So I add 10 to this to get 1. So 1 is a valid number in mod 5. So minus 9 is nothing but 1 in mod 5, right? So therefore, determinant A is nothing but 1. So we have 1 by 1. So similarly here we have minus 4 and minus 3. So to get the values of minus 4 and minus 3 in mod 5, I need to add 5 to these two numbers. So 3, minus 4 plus 5 is 1, minus 3 plus 5 is 2, 1. So essentially I need to find the inverse of 1, isn't it? So inverse of 1 is 1 itself. So therefore 3, 2, 1, 1 is the inverse of matrix A. Now is it true? Let's multiply A inverse and A, and let us check if we get the identity matrix. So we have 3, 2, 1, 1, multiplied with 1, 3, 4, 3. So we got to remember that the operation is in mod 5, right? So 3 into 1 is 3 plus 8, 2 into 4. Next, 3 into 3 is 9 plus 2 into 3 is 6, and then we have 1 into 1 is 1 plus 4 into 1 is 4, 1 into 3 is 3 plus 1 into 3 is 3. So what do we get? We get 3 plus 8 is 11, 9 plus 6 is 15, 1 plus 4 is 5, and 3 plus 3 is 6. All these values should be written in mod 5. So 11 in mod 5, its remainder is 1. 15 in mod 5 is 0. 5 in mod 5 is 0. 6 in mod 5 is 1. So we get the identity. So A equals 2, 3, 7, 8 in mod 26. So we need to find the inverse of A in mod 26. Right? Okay. So let me find its determinant. It is 2 into 8 is 60 minus 7 into 3 is 21. Right? So we get minus 5. Minus 5 is an invalid number in mod 26. So what do we do? We need to add 26 to get its positive value. So we get 21. Right? So essentially I have 1 by 21 into interchange the principal diagonal elements and negate the other elements operating in mod 26. Right? So of course, what is minus 7? Minus 7 in mod 26 is -19 and this is 23. So now I need to find the inverse. So 1 by 21 is nothing but 21 inverse into this matrix. So we need to find the inverse of 21 and mod 26. So what does that mean? That essentially means that when I multiply 21 with another number in mod 26, I get 1 in mod 26. Right? So that is the meaning of inverse. A given number into another number. If I get 1, then these two are inverses of each other. Right? So, for example, A into A inverse should give me the identity element. So if I multiply 21 with another number and find the value in mod 26, if I get 1, then this number would be the inverse of 21 and 21 would be the inverse of this number. Right? So if the number is very large, we have to find the inverse using extended Euclidean algorithm, which has already been discussed in the previous video session. You can go through the link which has been mentioned in the description. Right? Else, if the numbers are small, we can try by inspection, right? Now, the valid numbers could range between 1 and 25, since we are operating in mod 26, which starts from 0, of course, so 0 cannot be the inverse. So, by trial and error, 21 into 1 in mod 26, check whether it's 1. 21 into 2 in mod 26, check whether it's 1. So, we can do it by trial and error or use extended Euclidean algorithm, right? So we find that 21 into 5 in mod 26 gives me 1. Right? So 21 into 5 in mod 26 gives me 1. So this is 1 of 5. Right? So 26 if I divide this by 26, we get 4. So 1 out of 4 so you get 1 as the remainder, right? So inverse of 21 is 5. So now what we do is we multiply this matrix with 5. So 21 inverse is 5, so I write 5 here. So 5 into 8, 23, 19, 2, mod 26. So this is not it. Multiply these numbers, 5 into 8, 5 into 19, 5 into 23, 5 into 10, and get the values in mod 26. Right? So 5 into 8 is 14, mod 26, and so on. So the final answer what we get is 14, 11, 17, and 10 in mod 26. So this is A inverse. Right? Okay. So now, so the problem states that Friday is the plain text. It is encrypted using a 2x2 matrix to give P Q C F K U. So this is the ciphertext. So we need to find K, the encryption matrix K. So if the plain text is given and if K is given, then I can multiply matrix K into the plain text alphabets, taking two at a time, and get the ciphertext. So it is a straightforward problem. But here in this case, the plain text has been given, the ciphertext has been given. We need to find K, right? Okay. So we know that C equals K into P mod 26, because nothing has been mentioned. So we assume that we only have 26 characters. So we are operating in mod 26, right? Okay. So now K is a 2 cross 2 matrix, right? So we, let's consider, let us first write the numerical equivalence. So F is 5, R is 17, I is 8, D is 3, A is 0. And Y is 24, right? So these are the plain text values. So next, for P, Q and so on, so B is 15, Q is 16, C is 2, F is 5, and K is 10, and U is 20. So these are the numerical values what we have taken, right? So let's consider the first two. So I get PQ equals K, which is unknown, 2 cross 2, into the plain text for F and R. So let me write the numerical values of P and Q. So P and Q is 15, 16. And here we have 5 and 17. So similarly, considering the next two, we have C and F. So C is 2, F is 5, K, which is a 2 cross 2 matrix, is I and D. So I is 8 and D is 3. So how do we get K? So the only way in which we can get K is so we have C equals K into P. The only way in which we can get K is P inverse into C equals K. Right? So now this is 2 cross 1. This is 2 cross 2, and this is 2 cross 1. So we cannot find the inverse of a 2 cross 1 matrix. So what do we do? Let us consider two columns of C and two columns of P together. So therefore, I have 15, 16, 2, 5 equals K, which is a 2 cross 2 matrix, 5, 17, 8 and 3. Right? So the first row of K into the first column here will give me this element. The first row of K into the second column will give me this element. The second row of K into the first column will give me 16. And the second row of K into this column will give me 5. Right? So therefore, what is K? So K essentially is So let us call this as Q dash. k, and let me call this as p dash, right? So how do we get k q dash into p dash inverse equals k into p dash inverse, right? So I need to multiply q dash into inverse of p dash to give k, to get k. So we have k equals q dash, which is 15 to 16, 5, into inverse of this, which is 5, 8, 17, 3 inverse, operating in mod 26. Right? Okay, so let's try to find the inverse. So what is the inverse? So we have 5, 8, 17 and 3. We need to find the inverse. So the determinant is 15 minus 17 into 8. Okay, so that gives me minus 121. Okay, so since we are operating in mod 26, so this gives me minus 121. We are operating in mod 26, so add multiples of 26 till we get the first positive number, so we get 9. Right? Okay, so this is determinant of this matrix. So we have called this matrix as P dash. So determinant of P dash is this. Right? Okay. So now we have 1 by 9 into interchange the principal diagonal elements. So we get 3, 5 and negate the other elements, minus 17 and minus 8 in mod 26. So we need to find the inverse of 9, right? So inverse of 9 into something in mod 26 should give me 1 in mod 26. So this is very simple. We know that 9 into 3 is 27, which is 1 more than 26. So therefore the inverse of 9 is 3. So 3 is the inverse of 9. So therefore we have 3 into 3 minus 8 plus 26 is 18, minus 17 plus 26 is 9, 5 in mod 26, right? So multiply the numbers and find the value in mod 26, so we get 9 and then 2 and then 1 and then 15. So this is P dash inverse, right? So we have called this as Q dash and this is matrix P dash, right? So this is Q dash into P dash inverse. So now multiplying Q dash with P dash inverse, we get matrix K. So let us multiply these two. So what is Q dash? So we have 15, 2, 16 and 5 multiplied with the inverse of P dash, which is 9, 2, 1 and 15 in mod 26. Right? So you multiply and find the value in mod 26, we get the answer, I'll write the answer, 7, 8, 19 and 3. So this is the encryption matrix K, of course, operating in mod 26, right? So all the other examples would be much easier, where if you're given the plain text, And if you're given the encryption matrix, it is just encryption matrix K into the plain text would give you the ciphertext. Okay?